All right, from Fort Hood to the Charlie Hebdo attack, as the war on terror gets more dangerous, it seems the battle for political correctness has also reached an all-time high. My next guest knows this firsthand. He's a decorated intel officer who was ousted by the Pentagon. He says for speaking out against Islamic extremism, or as some would say, calling it like it is the administration letting political correctness get in the way of defeating the enemy? Stephen Coughlin is a former Army intel officer and author of this book, Catastrophic Failure, Blindfolding America in the Face of Jihad. So, Stephen, did you feel as though you nailed who our enemy was and gradually had been told to pull back?
Yes, that's exactly what happened. I was brought into the Pentagon as an intelligence officer. The goal of intelligence is to define the enemy as he defines himself. It's not my fault he defines himself as a jihadi to impose Islamic law. They asked me to purge that from my research. I refused, so they purged me. The question becomes, if you can't analyze al-Qaeda based on what they say they're fighting for, how can you analyze them at all?
Right, and I guess the fear is, well, if you say that we're at war with Islam, you're fighting billions of people, let's disseminate and say the war against radical Islam. Do you have a problem with that?
I don't have a problem with the idea at all. I mean, our goal is to define the enemy. You know, at a certain point, there were just Nazis in Germany, but when the Nazis took over, they controlled Germany, and we had to fight all of Germany. And what we're seeing is that type of process cycle up. So I don't have to prove what true Islam is to all Muslims. I just have to prove what Islam is to the people we're fighting, and they think these things.
So let's look at the National Intelligence Report. In 2004, it mentioned the word jihad 126 times, Islam 145, 322 times, Muslim 145, and Sharia law twice. Now let's look in 2009. Zero jihad, zero Muslims, zero Islam, zero Sharia. Is there a danger in that?
There's an absolute danger. You cannot target what you will not define. And I think we think of the war on terror and what's going on over there. But I think the people we're up against feel that they can win the war over here by influencing how we conceptualize the nature of the threat and miss all the time. Because if I can't use the concepts of jihad that al-Qaeda say they rely on, then I can't understand what they're going to do.
But what people say, like the president, is, well, they bastardize Islam and use it as an excuse for their extremist behavior. What's the truth?
Well, I would say, like, for example, President Obama said ISIS is not Islamic. But in December, without supporting them, Al-Azhar, the most prestigious center of Islam in the world, said they are Islamic. So, I mean, if it's good enough for them, it's good enough for me.
And Steve, would people reading your book go, well, he's just bitter, he got fired. What do you say to them?
Well, I never really asked to do it in the first place. I was a reserve officer, was brought in, and I was quite successful at what I did. And then I left, and they brought me back in as a consultant. And I was successful again. So, yes.
I would like it much more if you were on our side disseminating this intelligence. Catastrophic Failure, Blindfolding America in the Face of Jihad. Stephen Coughlin, thanks so much. Coughlin, I should say.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you very much.
Take care.
All right, coming up straight ahead.